Hey guys, what's going on? There's another update on the conversion. Now what we are doing today is we are drilling the holes to mount the metal. Unfortunately, this supposedly genuine 5-star quality Yamamoto thing exploded. This is a cheap plastic piece of shit. Don't get anything made by this company. It's a total frickin' ripoff. Look, Genuine Parts. Oh, look. Hey, Genuine Parts. Yeah, so I'm back to redneck starting it for the time being. I found a small engine parts place a few miles from here, so we're gonna go stop by there. Also, the sprocket I ordered is upstairs. Unfortunately, they gave me the wrong type of sprocket. They gave it for a number 4041 chain, not a number 35 chain. So it did fit on the spline, but it didn't, you know, it wasn't the right type of chain, so I was kind of pissed about that. But we got another one on the way now, another sprocket on the way. We have an express shipping, so it should be here in a couple days. It should be here actually on Wednesday, say Sunday. So I'm gonna go ahead and do a time lapse, and I'm gonna drill some of this crap. There we go. Got that hole finished. Now I'm going to mount the bracket. Get a screwdriver real quick. Well, it turns out I'm actually running into the iron, so I'm a little bit too far forward. I'm drilling into that piece right there, and there's no way she can see the holes right there. You see that? Probably not, but the holes are right in there. So I need to be drilling a bit further back. Here, let me lift up this and let's see where I'm hitting. Right there is where I'm hitting, so I should probably drill right next to this one right here. So that's what I'm gonna do real quick. Okay, that one's done. Now let's start drilling the hole for the second mounting slot. All right, so I'm about 75% through everything, and so far it's pretty it's holding up pretty damn well. Except for this one, I kind of overdid it and I made the holes too close. But that could be fixed. I'll just get like a smaller one of these. But I now have only one more to drill right here. And after that, it's gonna be completely in place. And then I already know how it's gonna line up with the sprocket, because I just slipped the clutch on there, and I placed it where I lined it up with the very, very tip of the spline, with the very end of it, and it doesn't even need to go all the way forward. So I'm gonna drill this last hole, and see you guys in a bit. So before I drilled the other two holes, I wanted to see where exactly the engine would sit. So there's the hole right there, and there's where the engine mounts are. They're a bit further back than you would expect. So there's a lot of space for the engine to move back. I can't see right now, the camera can see. I think there's about 2 or 3 inches, maybe 2 inches of clearance from the starter motor and alternator to the side here, because I'm gonna be sliding it back to tension the chain. So since this electric start I'll no longer be using it, I should probably just like remove it. But I don't know. I mean, I was thinking of hooking up with a fan to the alternator, but we'll see. So, as you can see right now, it is, how I know is I got a ruler on the sprocket. Actually, no, I got the chain and I just lined it up pretty much. Used my best instinct, and so far it should do pretty good. All right. Got all the brackets in, and it is very sturdy. It's not going to go anywhere. It may squeak a little bit if you pull on it really hard, but that's about it. I also got I found a shorter bracket, and I replaced it. I replaced this one. So I just have to clean all this stuff out, and I'm gonna position the engine in real quick so I can see how everything lines up. All right, here we are. The engine's just sitting in right now. Looks like it's about lined up. The sprocket I'm gonna get, it's kind of like this, but let's pretend the gear is out. Let's pretend the gear is right here, and there's just other space right here. So it's actually gonna be sticking out a bit more, which is good. So then I don't have to force it to go too far forward, because I'm a little bit limited now because of this bracket. It's about a millimeter or so, maybe a couple millimeters from the bracket itself. That's perfectly fine. So I'm glad that it fits. Let me tell you about the sprocket I'm gonna get. Here's an old crappy Max Torque clutch that I had on my old go-kart. See how it has these, how it has this keyway? It has these little Allen heads right here that screw in to the clutch. The sprocket's gonna be like that. It's gonna have a keyway and 2 Allen heads, and it's gonna be a 1-inch bore, not, this is a 3/4 bore. It's gonna slide onto the spline, and we might have to weld it, but I'm just gonna get my drill and just drill the Allen keys, drill the little Allen screws down into the spline. And this spline is like the toughest part in the golf cart, so I doubt it'll get damaged. And if the screws give out, then I'll just, no big deal, I'll just weld it. So, by the way, if you're looking to get a really, really good clutch, don't get a Max Torque. They're $34 on eBay, but just for an extra $10, you can get a Hillard clutch which will outlast and outperform the Max Torque clutches very, very well. And I think that just about wraps it up. So I've probably spent about 15, maybe 20 minutes drilling these holes. So more updates on this project soon. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys later.